Hello, and welcome to your free training course for Windows 7. In this video, I will look at virtual hard disks. In the previous videos, I touched on the virtual hard disks as a solution for dual booting. In this video, I will explore virtual hard disks in more detail. Virtual hard disks are used in virtualization solutions like Hyper-V and VirtualPC. A virtual hard disk is contained in a single file. Because of this, it is easy to move a virtual hard disk from one computer to another computer. You can even move a virtual file between a virtual PC solution, such as Hyper-V, to a physical computer. If you want to make changes to a virtual hard disk, the virtual hard disk can be mounted under the operating system, allowing you to make changes to the file. As shown previously, virtual files are a great choice for dual booting. Once you are done with the file, remove it afterwards. No need to repartition your hard disk. In order to boot from a virtual hard disk or VHD file, you require Windows 7 Enterprise or Ultimate Edition. In order to understand virtual hard disks better, I will install Windows 7 on a brand new computer and configure it to boot from a virtual hard disk. On my Windows 7 computer, I have already booted it from the Windows 7 DVD. From the start screen, I will accept the defaults. Select Install Windows, and then select the Edition of Windows. Accept the license agreement, and lastly, select Custom Advanced to install a fresh copy of Windows 7. So far, the procedure has been exactly the same as if I were performing a clean install of Windows 7. This computer has one hard disk which has not been formatted yet. Before I can create the VHD file, I need somewhere to store it. If I select the option Drive Options Advanced, I can then select the option New to format the hard disk. In this case, I want to use all the free space on the hard disk in one partition, so I will select Apply, which will by default use all the available hard disk space. The setup program will give you a message saying that some space will be reserved for a system partition. This is normal, and when I press OK, you will see that two partitions have been created, one system partition and one partition for my operating system and files. The next thing I need to do is format the hard disk. When I select the option Format, I will get a warning saying that any data on the hard disk will be lost. I can't create the virtual hard disk using Setup. To create the hard disk, I need to use the command line tool Disk Part. To run Disk Part, press Shift F10 to open a command prompt and then type in Disk Part. From Disk Part, run the command Create VDisk, followed by File equals and the file name of the VHD file. In this case, Windows has given the newly created disk the drive letter of E. This will change when the system boots up. If you are not sure which drive letter is being used, run the command List Volume. Next, I need to enter in the size of the hard disk. In this case, I will make it 60 gigabytes. By default, the type will be fixed, which you can set with option Type equals Fixed. The fixed option means that the hard disk space will be allocated immediately, or in other words, a 60 gigabyte file will be created. This gives you better performance. Microsoft recommends that you use the fixed disk type in production systems. The next type is expandable, also referred to as dynamic. When you use this type of virtual hard disk, the file expands as more data is written to the hard disk. This means your virtual hard disk file is proportional to the amount of data stored on the virtual hard disk. The advantage of this is that your virtual hard disk is smaller, but the performance of the virtual hard disk is slower when compared to a fixed virtual hard disk. For this reason, Microsoft recommends that expandable virtual hard disks not be used on a production system. The hard disk has been created, but before I can start using it, it needs to be attached to the system. To do this, I need to select the hard disk using the Select VDisk command, followed by the file name of the virtual disk. Once selected, I then need to run the command Attach VDisk. Now that the virtual hard disk is attached to the system, I can now exit disk part and the command prompt and return back to Windows Setup. Once I select the option Refresh, my virtual hard disk will appear and I can select it and install Windows 7 on it. You will notice a warning at the bottom of the screen. If I open the warning, you can see a message stating that Windows can't be installed on this disk because the BIOS may not support it. Assuming your BIOS supports this kind of booting, you should be all right to install Windows, and you can ignore this message. Windows 7 will now install. I will pause the video and return once Windows 7 has finished installing and I have logged in. This computer now has only one operating system installed on it, and that operating system is running on a virtual hard disk file. If I open Windows Explorer and access the D drive, you can see the virtual hard disk file. One file contains all the operating system files and user data for this computer. If I open the C drive, you can see that the C drive just looks like a normal Windows 7 install. The only difference is that the data from the hard disk is being stored on the D drive on the virtual hard disk. If I open up Computer Management and go into Disk Management, you can see the virtual disk has appeared in blue. If I right-click on Disk Management, I have the option to create additional virtual disks and also to attach a virtual disk. Attaching a virtual disk is one way you can perform maintenance on a hard disk. For example, attaching a virtual hard disk to your system would allow you to add and remove files from the virtual hard disk. If I run a command prompt with administrator privileges, I can run the command bcdedit with the switch /v. Here you can see that the virtual hard disk has been added to the boot menu and that it is the only operating system on this computer. If you created a standard VHD file, you could deploy it to many computers in your enterprise. Once completed, you could in the future perform maintenance on the file. Unlike WIM files, there are not too many ways to perform maintenance on your VHD files. To perform maintenance, you can download the offline machine servicing tool from the Microsoft website. Even though this is a free download, it does require System Center Virtual Machine Manager to be installed on your system, which is a commercial product available from Microsoft. Otherwise, you can always make changes by mounting the virtual hard disk under Windows Explorer. If you already have a Windows 7 computer in WIM format and want to deploy it to a VHD file, you have a few options. First, you can deploy the image to a virtual hard disk using ImageX. To use ImageX with a virtual hard disk, simply attach or mount the virtual hard disk and then ImageX with the switch Apply. In our previous video, I went through the whole process with a physical hard disk. If you follow this procedure, adding the step to attach the virtual hard disk, you can use ImageX to deploy an image onto a virtual hard disk. If you have an existing WIM file and you want to convert it to a VHD file, Microsoft offers a free tool available for download from their website. The tool requires Windows Automated Installation Kit to be installed, another free download from the Microsoft website. To demonstrate how to use the WIM to VHD script, I will change to my computer running Windows 7 with Windows AIK installed. First of all, I need to open Internet Explorer and perform a search for WIM to VHD. This will give me the MSDN website that contains the script. Once I open the website, all I need to do is select Downloads and download the script to my local computer. The download is only a script. There is no installer for the file. Once downloaded, I next need to open a command prompt with administrator privileges to run the script. Once I change directories to run the script, I can run cscript followed by the name of the script. Cscript is software that runs a number of different kinds of script. For example, I can also run vbscript files as well as others. In this case, the script is a Windows script file. I need to also enter in some parameters. The first is /wim followed by colon, and then the path to the WIM image. In this case, I will use the install.wim file on the Windows 7 DVD. Next, I need to enter in /vhd colon and the name of the output VHD file. Finally, since this WIM file contains multiple images, I need to enter in /sku colon and then the reference number for the image that I want to use. In this case, I will use the first image. The script will now run and the original WIM file is converted to a VHD file. This is the last video on imaging and installing Windows. There is a lot to imaging Windows, but if done correctly, it will save you a lot of time in enterprise environments. In the next video, I will look at using device drivers for Windows.